Welcome back. Wow, thank you for choosing to click to come to the website, you know, to come and learn more about the entire project. So my name here is Brian, and seated next to I have an envelope here for FAME International Church. This is where people put in their, you know, their partnerships, and the whole program is really led by the Spirit of God. For 3 years, the same Spirit of God has been at this place, at the church. Miracles have happened. If you've gone through all the other content, if you go through this website, you'll see the YouTube channel down there. Just take a look at what's happening at this place. So my name is Brian, and I'm just chosen by the people at this church to share the message. But more than that, I'm chosen by the Spirit of God, because the pastors leading us is Apostle Julius, and he's this great man. Went to school, has over 4 bachelor's degrees. But in the end of it all, God showed him that he was supposed to lead his people. He was supposed to, you know, get to the kingdom of God and the anointing of God. And he's a pretty gifted man with healing. You know, I've seen him do dream interpretation. I've seen him prophesy quite many things, okay? So coming back to the message, it is a seed, tithe, and faith. I want to go back in real life, guys. I want to just talk about real life of what's happening. The first man in modern history that had a lot of wealth and that offered tithe ever since his first paycheck. So, as you can see on the top, do you know that the world's top billionaires offer tithe? Let's take a look and let's dive into this. It all begins with the Word of God. Matthew 19:26. It's very clear. The power of God makes everything possible. So I'll give you a real life example. One day I was a real life youth here in Africa, surviving on $1 or $2 a day, and that's like a normal thing here downtown Africa. But look, I got a different way that I began doing things. First thing, I'll give you an example of what a seed is. Right now I have my dream business, and of course I'm looking at more that is coming. I'm living my dream apartment, but I'll give you one thing that has been like my whole password for getting this together. So I remember when I was looking for space for my first business, so I got this $100. So that's what you can call a seed, okay? It's like faith, which is like practical, tangible, something that you feel at your heart. But it's like trusting someone, and we can call that someone God, you know, to get something. It's like do God's work and let God do something for you. So I gave this seed to, you know, Apostle Julius, and he didn't know what I was actually up to. And I spoke spiritually in me, and I'm like, you know, God, I want to allocate the best space for my business. And I was thinking averagely, I was thinking of 20 people that are coming to work out at my gym, okay? Actually, what I ended up getting, yeah, as you can see, this whole place. Now, I got a place that is straight up to the road. That was later on, because it's like seed time harvest. So when time went, I began looking for this place, okay? And at first it was kind of hard, but in the end I ended up getting one of the best places. Now I thought about getting 20 people, that is like marketplace people coming at my business. The place that I got can get me like 100 people, okay? So now that's like an example of what you can call seed. Even right here on this little envelope, there's something small that I'm gonna show you. It's written here. That is Samuel 9, First Samuel, that is chapter 9, verse 7 to 8. It says like this: what can we give the man, Prophet Samuel, what we have? The servant answered him. Look, he said, I have a quarter of shekel of silver, that's in bracket, they put money. I'll give it to the man of God so that he will tell us what way to take for the lost donkey to be found. So pretty much it began from the Old Testament. It is as simple as, you know, a few Bible verses where people offered, you know, burnt sacrifices to God. A very good example is of Solomon. He offered a lot of his cattle, and in the whole end, he had wisdom and wealth. And you know, it's a mode of faith back to God. You know, I've heard one of Africa's best preachers, that's Pastor Robert Kayanja, and the message he has in one of his books is like, you know, God's greatest need is to be believed, and man's greatest need is to be loved. But the whole thing in believing God is faith, and the word seed stands for faith right there. So this is like practical faith, active faith, and something like that. So pretty much getting back to the word tithe, So at first, pretty much I thought that tithe is like something religious, something like a culture in church, and something not effective. Now, when I began to put up my first business, now this is another real life example, okay? It's an extract out of what I've done before. So I began the whole entire project. As you can see this video right here, okay? I was supposed to renovate the whole entire place and it was costing a lot of money, okay? So many people thought that I had like a savings with me, but not really. I had a working strategy and it was tithe. So by then I was offering 20% of each and every paycheck money that I achieved in a day. And look, I experienced a spike. I realized that tithe is principality. These two things are principalities. And they're like things that are a command in the power of God that if you do this, it's declared already it's done. If you tithe basically puts like some kind of passive style in whatever you're earning. So I realized that when I began tithing 20%, I was going in for a double anointing. It became a double portion of everything that I got back. At first, when I offered 10%, it was like no more. It was like I was being average. And when I began to give 20%, it became like a double tap of everything that I was doing. It was crazy. So I began to put up this entire project in no time. I didn't have any savings. A lot of people thought that I had money saved, like many other people begin businesses, but I didn't have any savings. So I began putting up the whole thing 90 days down the road. It was done. Out of only giving tithes, 20%. It kind of feels like heavy at the heart to get 20% of your money and give it back. But if you think like an entrepreneur, you'll find that this is a working faith, because if you're giving and it's all coming back, it's passive. Yeah, that's how it works. So getting to the partnership, the whole partnership, you're basically not partnering with the church as the building itself, but pretty much with the invisible spirit of this faithful, powerful God. You see, when God loved the world so much, he had to plant a seed. He had to sow a seed. He offered his own son, Jesus. Secondly, we know the likes of Abraham, Solomon. Abraham believed in God. He was willing to offer his own son at that late age to God. That is sowing, that is faith, okay? The likes of Solomon. So now, you know, summing up the whole thing, how do you know that you are making a deal with the Holy Spirit? If you're offering $1 million and you want it to come to Africa, how do you know that you ain't just giving us that money, but you are actually making a deal with the Holy Spirit? You know, how do you know that? So there are quite things that you can do. First of all, you can go into a fasting and praying. You can fast and pray, go one-on-one with your God and find out the truth. Secondly, you can reach out to your pastor and inquire, show him this video, show him this website. Let him go in his higher rank of anointing to find out about this. And obviously he's going to come back with one answer. One answer, because the God that has done these things in my life, I came out to sit down and to testify for that God, is the same God your pastor serves. He's the same God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. He's the same God of Solomon. So let's get the partnership program together. So you're going to look down. There are quite payments that you can use to send your seed. You can use Bitcoin, Bankwire, Western Union. I've recorded a video explaining how you can use each and every platform. So everything is really, really, really simplifying. So what happens when you have sent your partnership? What's next? So you're going to send to us an email of the payment details. Okay, the email is below. You'll see it. seedtithefaith@gmail.com. After that, you're going to send us your prayer request, like a small prayer request. You're going to find that on the page where you make the payment from, like your request for prayer, your full names, okay? So we are fasting for 90 days. We shall dedicate you to the throne of mercy of God, okay? Because this is involved with the Holy Spirit of God, and we have to dedicate whosoever, you know, contributes to this program. And then lastly, we want to make this a mighty move of God among his nations of the world. We want to prove to people that the God of John D. Rockefeller, the oldest American of all time in modern history, who offered tithe ever since his first paycheck, as you can read on the article here, that is Billionaire Who Tithe on CNBC.com, We want to prove to you that, we want to prove to the world that it's the same God that is working, that is leading this program. It's the same God of Abraham and Solomon. We want you to shoot a video, because the Holy Spirit will allocate you wherever you are. So shoot that video, testify about what happens, because the thing is, you do God's work and God does fulfills your request, and that's how it works. Thank you so much for watching the video. I remain Brian, okay? And I'll be so happy, and I will come to the church, physical address. We are all one family in the kingdom of God. Amen.